Hello, welcome to Radio Rubber Room. We're coming to you from Soundcheck Studios.
How you doing, Derek?
I am living the dream.
As am I.
Living the dream.
As am I. What's your dream today?
It's very... I'm not going to remember it.
You're
it's like one of those
it.
Dreams. Like,
it's one of those dreams where like you just know it's a good dream.
And have pieces of it.
And like you felt...
It's a little weird.
So like you felt really happy and like...
It's hard to say.
Okay. So you're not really quite sure how you feel about this dream or what it is.
Yeah.
Okay.
Exactly.
Cool.
Yeah. Specifically.
Sweet. I had a dream that I was going to do a podcast with a bunch of horses and a fish.
Are we still dreaming?
Go figure. I'm pretty sure I'm still dreaming. Like you said, living the dream.
So I'm
dude.
Just in your dream?
No, like literally living the dream.
Oh. I'm sleeping the dream.
So we've got Seahorse in Soundcheck Studios with us today. Thanks for being here, guys.
Yeah.
Ahoy.
Can we go ahead and introduce you and what you do in the band? Are we talking horses and talking fish, right?
That's correct.
Okay, I was just making sure.
We're just like you.
You are.
Yeah.
Clearly. So let's go ahead and get your names and what you would play in the band.
Brown Horse on the
let's
left.
Let's start with Brown Horse on the left. Exactly.
Yeah. All right.
Way to be right there, Derek.
I'm Sammy, and I play the bass.
Hey,
hi,
Sammy.
Hey. How's it going?
So what's your favorite snack?
Crimped oats.
Crimped oats?
Crimped oats?
Sugar cubes, but that's only on the top.
Sugar cubes?
Yeah.
Okay. That's what I forgot.
Sugar
vitamin C.
No, I brought, I got chocolate wafers for the horses and I totally forgot them.
This interview's over.
Next time.
Black Horse with the black Sabbath shirt on.
I am Blackhead.
And you?
I used to get blackheads really bad, but I don't know.
that's me.
Yeah.
Hence, like, the horse mask is a good thing. Yeah? No? Maybe? Yeah? Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
I agree.
So long as we're on the same page. High five. I got you. Just go that way. There you go. Perfect. And you play what in the band? In Seahorse.
Guitar.
You play guitar. Of course. Yeah. Blackhead can play guitar. That makes sense. And over here, slightly darker brown horse to my left. What's going on, buddy? Whoa.
Hi.
You okay there?
Yeah.
Yarg?
Yeah, I play the saxophone.
Okay.
My name, Captain No Beard.
Captain No Beard. Got it. And what is this you have with you, Captain No Beard?
This is my son. This is our son, sorry.
Okay. All right. So.
It's very beautiful.
I love it. You guys look very happy.
Guess we are.
Adorable.
It's just permanent.
Adorable.
It's because we yard.
Aw, you yard. You're adorable.
Yard.
Adorable. And who is your partner? Will you introduce them for us?
Yeah.
My name's Turtle.
Turtle?
Oh.
Yeah.
Turtle. It's very nice to meet you, Turtle. And you play drums in the band?
Yes. Yeah.
So, how did Seahorse come together?
Well,
we stormed the Seven Sea about 400 years ago. But horses don't live for 400 years.
Mm-hmm. I've noticed that.
But Seahorse was never just a horse.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
They've always been around. We're
okay.
just the first to make it here.
You're the first to make it here?
Well, here.
As in Richmond, Virginia, or...?
Well, North America.
North America.
Back in the day, the Seahorse came over on land bridges from China.
Okay, I've heard about those.
Yes, between Siberia and Alaska.
Right.
And they made their way down over thousands of years until they hit Richmond, and this is where we are.
And this is where you are. And then, and so how did you guys decide that this was the right time and place to start a band to kind of make surf rock cool again?
We're prophets.
Prophets?
Yes,
aye. Of the surf gods.
Aye.
Prophets of the surf gods.
Yes.
Okay, so we're going to find out way more about that after the break. But in the meantime, can we get where we can find your music and where people can tune in to like find all your next shows and stuff coming up?
There's this brand new thing. I don't think anyone's ever tried it.
Mm-hmm.
It's called iTunes.
It's called iTunes. Okay, so Seahorse has recordings on iTunes?
We are not on iTunes.
You are not on iTunes. Okay, never
we are on Bandcamp right now.
Bandcamp. But Bandcamp.
And you do like apples, I'm sure.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I don't believe in an iTunes.
I don't believe in an iTunes either. I believe in like solid tunes.
I listen to all my music through apples.
So, we can find your music at Bandcamp?
Yeah, correct. We have an album coming out.
I heard that. I'm excited about that. I'm not gonna lie, I'm really excited about that. Are you guys super stoked on that?
Yeah.
When's it coming out?
I don't know.
Sometime soon, though.
November, maybe.
Okay, maybe November.
We're hoping.
Alright, cool. Well, we'll
we're
talk more about that.
We're still waiting for another message, really.
Okay. Alright, again, we're gonna get back to this and all of the updates from the Prophets of the Sea Gods.
A lot to delve into.
And the Seahorse, and where you can find their music and upcoming shows and all that stuff when we get right back from this break, right?
Yeah, before we go to break two, if you haven't noticed, Radio Rubber Room does have a crowdfunding campaign that's been going on. It's an ongoing thing. There's different tiers. You can find out about it.
There's a link at the bottom of this episode on the RadioRubberRoom.com.
That's one of the spots. It should be on our new site soon. You can find the link on the Podbean and every posting. But we do have, there's one tier that's, you get a sticker, t-shirt, and a chance to guest host.
It's true. And we have our very first guest host with us tonight.
Yeah. Did that tier that gets the guest hosting spot. So we have Cara in the building. Very excited. Cara, are you in there
in
the control room?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. Hello. Thank you.
So we're gonna get her in here for the rest of the interviews, asking questions and stuff with us. Very stoked about that. But we are going to get to a tune, get to a break, and when we get back, we'll be talking to Seahorse more. But right now, this is Downbeat Switch. They just released this album this weekend.
So excited.
Track off of it. This is Broad Street Lullaby here on Radio Rubber Room.
They say curiosity killed the cat. I don't think that's true unless the weird kid down the street is named Curiosity.
This band is killing it!
Hell yeah.
Hey, what's going on with that guy? And this chick? Oh my god! Everyone's turning into zombies!
No, not zombies!
I think they're hungry. We need Chef X!
Chef X!
Sausage stars!
Whoa! Nice shooting, Chef X! This one's still a zombie!
Burger! Stat!
Yeah,
yay! Chef X saved the day!
The Camel, 1621 West Broad Street, serving great music 7 nights a week until 2 a.m. and great food Sunday through Thursday from 3 p.m. to 12 a.m. 1 a.m. Fridays and Saturdays with brunch served every Saturday and Sunday 11 a.m. until 3 p.m. See you at the Camel!
Hey bras and brasiers, they say that those who don't remember history are doomed to repeat it. Well, I'm not going to let that happen to my bras and brasettes. So this is history with your bra Travis. I'm Travis. So back in the day, there was like this French guy named Napoleon. Yo, he was a short little brosif. Yo, and he was like, yo, bros, I'm going to take over Europe. It was like this bro had something to prove. Like he had some kind of complex or something. So his troops hoisted it up on his horse and he galloped to battles all over the continent. He won most of them too, scrappy little brosif. They say good things come in small packages. And that's why I have dubbed him Napoleon. Yeah. Bruh.
Live on Radio Rubber Room.
Yeah. Awesome.
You guys can come back and join us if you will over here. And then we've got Kara in here. How's it going, Kara?
How's it going, Kara?
It's going awesome. Thank
Welcome
you guys.
Welcome to Radio Rubber Room. So good to have you. Thank you so much for being a supporter. We appreciate it so much.
Yes. Most people following the dreams. Why not? Right.
Right. I mean, I'm living a waking dream right now.
Exactly.
You guys gonna come back over and hang out? Rob, don't forget the baby.
Of course.
Don't forget the baby.
It might be an actual dream. We're not sure.
I mean, I'm literally living my dream right now.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm pretty sure.
So, yeah, that was fun.
That was fun. I kind of felt like I was half in a James Bond movie and, like, half in, like, a surf rock 50s dance party movie.
Right.
You're correct.
Yeah. It was like Gidget meets James Bond, like, Gidget the Spy. Is kind of how I feel when I dance to your music. Like, well, Gidget the Spy. Can we make that a skit, Derek?
Sure. You try.
And have them do the soundtrack for it?
It's possible.
What do you think, guys?
Yep.
It would be hilarious.
We'll have to talk to our lawyers, but yeah.
Yeah, for now.
Is your lawyer also
You're interested. I like
horse?
It.
It's a long flight to Atlantis.
It is.
Now, are you guys from Atlantis?
No.
No.
We're from Portland.
Portland.
Michigan.
Michigan. Okay. Ooh. All right. So how'd you end up in Richmond? Like that sounds like an adventure.
That's where we were all born.
In?
Richmond.
I'm confused. I'm not gonna lie. I'm
What's wrong?
Confused. Wait, so you're from?
We're
from Portland, but we were born in Richmond.
Yeah. Mm. It's like beating a dead human sometimes with you.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah, we may want to not play that one.
I'm not.
Yeah. Okay.
Well, beat
but
a
I
dead
should.
Horse.
So. Yeah.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Yeah, I mean, like, why would you beat a dead anything? First of all, it's just a waste of time.
Oh, it's disappointing.
Yeah. Anyway, just saying.
You don't kick
it's
a
okay.
you don't
it's
kick
okay.
a horse when it's down.
Sorry.
Beat a dead
We're
human.
No, no, it's him. Let him down.
Aww, you're such a good dad.
He looks happy though. So yeah, now you guys, the surf music. You guys don't have a singer, and so I've been pondering this.
Dude, I've been. Okay, can we say it at the same time?
Well, Mr. Ed doesn't have offspring. I looked it up.
I was going with, like, have you thought about having a mermaid be... This is the thing that, like, I just kind of really... It would, like, make my dreams completely true if you guys had a mermaid lead singer.
See, the mermaids, the problem with them is...
There's a lot of problems.
There's a lot of problems with mermaids.
Oh,
you know.
God.
Black had dated a mermaid
We
once.
Can only... We are only legally obligated to get them from Atlantis, and the mermaids from Atlantis have big ego problems.
Ego problems. Yeah, you know, I've heard that. I mean,
they're unionized too.
And they're right to unionize too.
Yeah.
Okay. So,
real
well, you know, Virginia is a right to work state, so that does not apply in Richmond. Just
well,
so you know, so you know. So long as you're in Richmond, unionization doesn't actually apply. So I mean, like, you know, I feel like this might be one good
loophole for the mermaid
loophole
union.
For you know, the mermaid union.
No.
How do you guys feel about your reverse, like Pegasus's?
We don't talk about that.
Okay.
How
sorry,
about,
I'm sorry I brought it up.
But your relationships with the centaurs better?
Eh.
So what's your problem with the centaurs?
They look like us.
They look
But it's
like
the opposite.
You. Right.
Centaur is actually what I meant to say when I said Pegasus.
Pegasus are, you know, the flying ones. So, yeah.
Mm. We're not going to talk about Pegasus.
Okay, I won't. I'm sorry I brought it up. I apologize.
Won't happen again.
Yeah.
It's okay.
Thank you.
But I am interested in your dealings with the centaurs.
Well, we decided... Okay. Centaurs used to be horses. We used to be humans.
Mm-hmm.
And we just switched. We switched our heads with them. And...
Now, was it...
Sometimes, I guess, we really want them back.
So it's kind of this love-hate, like, separated at creation kind of thing.
Well,
I had just a penis!
There's a little resentment on each side. He's taking it kind of hard right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
So as a fish...
Sorry.
Who
right,
hangs
buddy.
Out with horses?
Yeah, they're cool.
Is this a thing that, like, you have to deal with regularly? Is this
Horse. We have to deal with him.
Extensive.
Yeah.
The extensive, like, horse lineage, like, old grudges.
I don't know, you know?
Does it, like, has it ever cost you gigs, like, playing with centaurs?
We dealt with the centaurs once, and that was it.
And that was
well,
it.
Well,
okay.
they all live up in Minneapolis, so
and
we try to just avoid that area of the country.
Okay, so no tours in Minneapolis.
I caught a centaur pocketing the gig money.
Okay. Okay.
That's what it is.
Now, are you gonna blame? But can you blame? You're fine. All right. But can you blame all centaurs for one centaur's fault?
No, but that's our premise.
That's what we're working on. No, we don't want to do that, but.
I mean, because tough. I feel like anti-centaur bias is a thing that we have to confront and talk about and be open with.
We all have to be aware of it, yes.
And work harder on addressing, you know?
Yeah, Harry Potter, centaurs.
Now, I don't assume you guys are better surfers, though.
No.
No?
I can't surf.
Is it an equilibrium thing, or?
Well, I'm 400 pounds, I can't surf.
I almost drowned trying to surf.
So, is this like, because you certainly don't look 400 pounds. I mean, like, you are killing the 400 pounds over there. You are actually 400 pounds. Like, you are killing it.
It's all in the emotional body.
It's okay.
Okay, so it's the weight of the extended lifespan and all of your experiences that all,
it's the weight of the past souls.
Gotcha. So horse people? Horse?
Centaurs. Horse people.
Seahorse. Okay, so seahorse are more in tune with their past lives than, say, humans.
Unfortunately, yes.
It's a burden.
It's a curse.
Yeah. Definitely a burden. But I mean, like, I feel more in touch with my soul when I hear your music.
That's accurate.
The thing with us, though, right? We weren't only living.
Car,
things.
I'm glad you agree. I'm glad you agree. I like it. Car, do you have anything that you want to know about seahorses? Because I mean, like, if you're like me, like, I haven't actually gotten a chance to talk to seahorses very often.
I mean, I haven't talked to them before. I'm really digging the sax. I really want to know where that emotional body comes from.
Yark.
You know, where that, because I don't, you know, I know
Captain
it's,
Nope.
You know, I know it's hard to do that underneath the water, so at least you're on the shores now, so. Where the sax
It all started one night at Emilio's. Seahorse existed, and I had a gig with me old grandmother's saxophone. And I played it, like she did, and that's why they liked it.
Aww. So your grandmother played the saxophone?
Yep, Eileen Garn.
Ooh. One of the, you know, great seahorses in the past, I would imagine.
Yep.
It may be difficult. I know it's probably difficult.
But you know what? Yeah. She passed her talent on to you, and there's absolutely nothing better than that. She lives on, right?
I love her.
The weight of all of those lives.
I love her.
Aww.
Somebody get him a sugar cube. I'm sorry.
Right? I'm so sorry. I forgot my chocolate cookies for you. Next time.
We got a little water.
I love him too.
Aww, there you go.
So let's real quick talk about the album.
Yes.
November-ish is what it's looking like.
I find that I feel like Seahorse don't really have a good grasp of like urgency of time.
Okay. So, yeah.
I actually have to be somewhere.
Oh, that's good.
Wait, what did he say?
He had to be somewhere. It was a joke.
That he had to be somewhere?
I said I had to be somewhere.
Okay.
Whoa.
Gosh.
This is what we're talking about.
Alright, so there's things that we need to work out. We'll get to that in the next segment. In the meantime, Derek, I think it's probably a good time for a break.
Let's do it. Let's take a break. We're going to hear from Hot Reader with Landmine here on Radio Rubber Room.
Woohoo!
Can you bottle it up? Can you age it like wine? Are you mending a dove? Are you caging it alive? Well, I don't want to live in a world where you and I speak a word without catching the room on fire. I can't sleep in a bed I can't hide beneath. Well, I don't want to live with a bullet between my teeth. Can you carry on? Can you shoulder the
The bigger they are, the harder they fall. The smaller they are, the harder they are to find.
Hey, this is your bro Travis, and I love history. I love coffee too. So today I'm gonna give you a little history about coffee. Coffee was discovered by a goat herder in Ethiopia who noticed his goats were getting all hype after eating some berries. He tried them and got all jacked too. So he took them to some monks who burned them because they thought they were the devil's berries. But they dug the smell and poured some boiling water on them. They totally dug this new beverage. It helped them concentrate during meditation and stuff. They started having a cup every day. The drink spread through the Middle East, Europe, and to the Americas. Yo, and in 1979, Jay Rostov opened up a coffee roastery in Richmond, Virginia. And Rostov's Coffee and Tea has been roasting coffee in Richmond for over 35 years now. They roast over 1,500 pounds a week on premises using a Jabez Burns roaster from the 1930s. But that's a history lesson for a different day, brah. Rostov's Coffee and Tea, 1618 West Main Street. Or find Rostov's Coffee at many of your favorite spots around town. Or even order online at www.rostovs.com. Rostov's Coffee and Tea, the best way to start your day in RVA, brah. Global warming is a serious problem. It can cause sweaty britches, most certainly leading to deadly crotch rot. That's why I use Cooling's Cooling Gel, the gel that generates a cooling effect that you can rub anywhere on your body. Apply Cooling Gel directly to the skin of any warm area and become immediately soothed as Cooling Gel goes to work for you, sending heat away from the body. It's so moist. Is that gonna be too much? Rub it into the flesh. Cooling's Cooling Gel doesn't just cool you. Millions of tiny bubbles pop, creating a tingling sensation. That's just, great.
It feels so good.
You'll surely stay hydrated as Cooling Gel's patented sweat barrier formula creates a long-lasting film that protects your pores. It's in my mouth. It's starting to get really cold. No more, please. No, seriously, no more, please. It's like 100 degrees out here. I'm freezing. Does it ever stop cooling? I think I'm getting frostbite. Long frigid winters bringing you down? Try Cooling's heating cream. It burns! It burns bad! My skin is blistering! Get it off of me!
Is nothing more than an emotional state, probably brought on, at least abetted by these confounded pills.
Will, you told me yourself these pills were from vampire bats.
Exactly, but Paul, that doesn't make you another Dracula. You found a strong suggestive influence there, that's all.
We'll be right back.
Now, that one started with a really interesting conversation. Do you guys want to tell us more about that when you get back over here? A little bit about what that song's about and how it came to be?
Sure.
Awesome.
So, yeah, Seahorse live here on Radio Rubber Room.
Seahorse. I never knew Seahorse were so musically talented. Guard, have you ever...
Had no clue.
I didn't know until
right?
last week.
But now I know.
Till last week at the Radio Rubber Room Showcase?
Then I found out.
Then you found out?
Oh, nice. Showcase?
We did a show with Camel, like we do every other Wednesday.
Right.
And these guys, these horses? Seahorses. These seahorses played there last, I guess 2 weeks ago. Almost two weeks ago.
2 weeks ago tomorrow.
2 weeks ago tomorrow, because we've got Red Leg Husky with Isaac Friend and Father Figure and Phil Gibbs tomorrow.
That is very true.
And that's an all-ages free show with Camel. See you there. But you guys were there 2 weeks ago. Tell me more about that. What was your experience like? Did you enjoy playing for Radio Rubber?
Yes, of course.
It was fantastic.
We love the lights because... we love the lights because our... that guy has... I don't know his name.
Billy Wallace.
Billy Wallace?
Billy Wallace.
Billy Wallace?
Of Vanzilli Productions.
You were there. It was the house show, the After Jawala Collective.
Yeah.
Them boys. They're great.
Jawala Collective.
Yeah,
you were talking about the after party for the Southern Bell show.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's what. Yeah.
At the Roanoke's.
Yes.
Yeah.
That was a fun time.
That was a great time.
He did a great job there, and I knew he was going to do a great job at Eel Camel.
Yeah. Absolutely.
I love
was it. Was it Billy running lights there, or was it Eric running lights there? I don't know. They work together all the time.
The bone guy.
Yeah, Billy.
Billy.
Yeah.
Love
him. Yep. Vanzilli Productions. Hit them up. They're awesome. And they do all of our Wednesday night shows and make our photographers' lives way easy and our videographers' lives way easy because it makes it way better to, you know, see a band if you can, you know, have lights on them, especially pretty.
Very interactive.
Did it take you back to, like...
To that night?
Well, I mean, I was going to say, like, is there a time where, like, I mean, like, you guys have so much more experience than I do. I feel like... there's like those lights remind me of some kind of like epic, like almost like Northern Lightsy kind of like primordial light.
Well,
show.
When we're in the horse trailer on the road and he's in his aquarium, mm-hmm. always reminds me of the lights that pass by through the little slits in a trailer.
There you go. Mm.
It's nostalgic.
There you go. So it kind of takes you to that like hummy, like happy place.
I suppose it does.
No, not for you. Not for you.
So do you.
It reminded me of a night at Mansion, 514.
Okay.
I mean, those are interesting nights.
Mm-hmm. So do you guys
talk about that night? I don't want to talk about it.
Let's not.
Do you guys have a decked out horse trailer?
Slash aquarium trailer.
Well, it's nice, but it doesn't have air conditioning.
Okay. It smells like fish.
It smells like fish,
and I hate riding in it.
And speaking of the aquarium, I've been impressed about how long you've been out of water.
I feel some tension.
Like, you can hold your breath, like, for quite a good period of time. I'm pretty impressed.
Yeah.
How long can you hold your breath? Like,
antiperspirant.
If you look closely at him, the only reason we let him in this band is if he could breathe or not. So we cut his gills out, and now he can breathe.
So he can breathe oxygen better.
Gotcha.
Yes.
We don't condone respiratory mutilation, but sometimes it just gotta happen.
Respiratory mutilation, I feel like, well, I mean, was it a choice?
Well, no.
No? You were forcibly respiratory...
We strapped him down.
Yeah.
I don't know how I feel about that.
It was a dark time.
I feel like it worked out for the best, though.
I mean, I feel like it... Well, I don't know. I can't speak for those who have been respiratorily mutilated.
He's been out of water for a good hour and a half now.
Derek, I feel like we should stop speaking on behalf of the victim here.
Well, at least we're here today. I mean, I'm happy to meet you all. I mean, it's...
We're happy to meet you.
Well, then,
and the music
I think
is
it was
great.
Worth it.
So there's
the music
that.
Is awesome.
Thank you.
What do you think? Like, the music is great. So, yay! Yeah, no?
That's
well,
so,
oh, okay.
So who taught you guys how to play your instruments? Like, what? Well, obviously we got your story, but the rest of the group, you know, who taught you? Because when a horse person comes and says, "Hey, teach me how to play guitar or bass," I'm sure you got some looks the first couple times.
Well, I learned from my grandfather. Some may know him as Zeus.
Okay.
All right.
Ooh,
and he told me it has to come from your scales. Not your scales on your instrument. Your literal fish scales.
I beg to differ.
Huh?
Mm. Yeah, I had... Well, you can't see them anymore, but...
Hades is my uncle.
Mm. Okay, so what is the seahorse relationship to Greek...
Poseidon.
Greek pantheon? Because I'm unfamiliar.
We were both just always wet and in the same place at the same time. And then he said, do you want to be my grandson?
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This was back before we met the centaurs. This was when I could still trot on the beach.
Yeah.
Oh.
So you were still like more horse?
Those
completely horse?
100%.
100% horse. Okay. All right. Now, were you all at one point? Well, obviously, you know, accepting. 100% horse?
I'd say so. I don't miss the hooves.
You don't miss the hooves?
No.
Now, I've always wondered about horseshoes. How do you feel about horseshoes?
The game?
No, like shoes being nailed into your hooves.
Oh. That's for the blingy horses.
That's for the what?
Or simple horses.
The simple horses.
How do you feel about the game?
You can't be accepted by them.
The game?
How do you feel about the game?
What game?
Horseshoes.
Trouble. Oh.
Oh, I love it.
Love it, yeah.
I've never reached that far of a sense of domestication yet.
So are you not pro horseshoes at all?
Well, I don't know. I've never.
You've
never been
them,
to like a cookout or anything.
You've never tried
that.
Them.
Oh wow.
No, I'm talking about like
horseshoes.
You've
yeah.
been
to the
like
beach.
Horseshoes, like on horse feet. Because they were horses, Derek.
Oh.
I was thinking
the
game.
Same page.
The game.
Well, have you guys ever watched Mr. Ed, or is that a touchy subject?
Yeah, I was actually researching his lineage earlier.
I mean, because he's a horse, of course.
Who's
that? Horse.
He's a horse.
Mr. Ed.
Of course.
He doesn't
the
have
famous.
Any offspring, because that's
he
what
doesn't.
I was kind of...
He doesn't. He had Roger. That was it. Yeah. Do you guys live, or are you just on your own? You're just savages of the land now?
I haven't heard that.
I graze where I feel I want to. Yeah.
I feel like we hit a sore subject. We may want to move along.
You
okay.
can.
No.
It's okay. Now, was he a friend of yours? Did you know Mr. Ed personally?
No.
No
idea.
No.
Okay. Mm. Just wondering.
I knew him!
Oh, you did? Yeah,
you knew him?
Yeah, didn't you?
He was a good guy.
Yeah? Do you know? Okay.
Okay.
So let's move on.
Yeah.
So, going back to this whole, like, super spy meets surf rock.
Yeah.
Thing. How did that become your sound? Okay, you know what? I think we should probably get to a break, Derek.
Yeah, we can get to a break.
And then we'll come back to, like, talking about the sound.
Yeah.
Pick it up.
Oh, inspired
okay.
you. What'd you listen
after
to in the trailer?
Live tune?
I love sound.
Yeah,
I do, too.
A good,
and
a
I love your sound.
Type of wave.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
We're going to get this next break. We're going to hear in this break from Kings, but we're going to kick it off with a brand new one. Actually, not released yet, new one, so kind of a debut from My Way. This is OMG.
And they will actually be releasing this album on November 30th at the Camel for Radio Rubber and Presents.
Also true.
See you there.
This is My Way with OMG here on Radio Rubber Room.
day? Do you make your money? Or is someone to blame? Someone to blame for your sense in the game. Someone to blame.
Hey guys, it's me, Sean, from Radio Rubber Room, here with another great product that I developed in Grandpa's tool shed. There's no hiding that I like to watch TV a lot. Watching TV can be made difficult whilst doing activities such as taking a shower, chopping vegetables, or driving a jet ski at night. Enough of that nonsense. My new product, it's totally amazing. Sean's TV helmet. I made it out of old microwaves. Sean's TV helmet condenses the mind-numbing entertainment you love into a convenient yet fashionable helmet. Simply plug my TV helmet into two electrical sockets. Wait just a few moments while it warms up. And just relax while the ear and nose plugs form fit to your head.
That's snug. Now make sure you're within close proximity to the X-ray receiver interface, and bam, in no time you have access to a staggering 11 channels that I personally approved. What's going on in Sean's bathroom? And Shades of Purple are guaranteed to be your two favorite TV helmet stations. Sean's TV helmet uses highly powerful lasers to turn your eye into the projection screen, beaming the TV directly into your head. It's just like real life. Want to change the channel? Just put the oral remote deep in your mouth and change channels with your tongue. The helmet also comes with refillable odor pustules, bringing your TV helmet experience to the next level with scents like old ham, a fermented banana, I hope, and what I think purple smells like. Having the power of dual microwave technology pulsing through your skull can get hot, so be sure to keep your scalp cooling cap in the freezer and wear before every use. Order my helmet today and I'll throw in my high-def eye drops. If you think you've seen the world, think again.
Fuckers act like they can even, like, kick me out of clothes and shit. I was just like, you know what I'm saying? He gonna be able to be while I'm outside. I'm already outside the club. Why y'all hating? Why y'all hating?
See ya, girl.
Yes.
Simon! Simon, sweetie!
What is it, Mommy? Kind of busy right now.
Simon!
Simon, baby, what are you doing in there?
I'm fighting my action figures right now, Mom, and using my imagination.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry, sweetie. I just wanted to let you know your favorite show, Radio Rubber Room, is on.
Oh, sweet. I'll be ready in 15 seconds.
I knew it was your favorite, sweetie.
Thanks, Mom. I love you.
I love you too, sweetie.
Yes. Radio Rubber Room, it's a show without any S's in the name.
Coco Chanel. Ow, ow, ow.
Exactly.
Love it.
Why is that so funny?
I'm quoting you.
That was beautiful.
Very beautiful. You're very beautiful.
I like that was more of like a like casual leisurely stroll on the beach, like a midnight stroll on the beach. I feel like there might be some frolicking involved in that one.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
That tune was about better days.
So what was that tune about?
Happier times.
Happier times?
That's better
times. Oh,
is happier times?
So it's about what it sounds like. We're just horses. We don't really have that bad of a life.
Don't have that bad of a life?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, is that on the air?
It was.
It is.
Oh, I knew that.
It was. That was great.
Happier times is about a movie called Shame.
Shane.
Oh,
Shane.
Anyone's ever seen it?
No.
It's
Shane.
Is that what? Tell me more about this movie.
About Shane.
It's about Shane.
Yeah.
It's an old country classic.
A country classic. Okay.
Yeah.
Tell me more.
It's about a little boy who befriends a town wanderer.
Yeah.
He's actually a pretty well-rounded cowboy.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's a quick draw. And he's an all-around handyman. He's great to have around the home. The problem was, he was too great to have around the home. So when it was time for him to drift on to the next town, as you do...
When you're a drifter.
When you're a drifter. Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When it was time for that...
He didn't drift.
Shane couldn't deal with it. Shane is the little boy in the family. No, that's wrong!
Oh, that is wrong. Shane is the
cowboy. Stop drinking Coors Light!
It's like the cocaine, you know. That's what we heard.
But the little boy in the movie, over and over, said, Shane.
Shane is the guy I just described.
The cowboy.
The cowboy, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
So Shane did move on, and the little boy couldn't deal with it. So Shane broke his little heart.
Yes, yes.
Exactly.
Oh, so that
cowboy
song,
break hearts, I hear.
That
I
song is about happier times when Shane was with the little boy.
Gotcha.
Wow.
Gotcha.
Better days.
We've
all got them.
Happier times, better days.
Got what?
How's your day going so far? Is it a good day?
Pretty good.
Pretty good?
I'm a
little
sleepy.
Blackhead, you look like you're having a rough day there.
He's always having a rough day.
Yeah?
Don't
gotta,
listen to him.
You've got to have some angst to like make a band, I think. You've got to have some angst
Something to pull from.
Yeah.
Put that soul in the song.
If everything's too easy and you're too grateful and it's too happy, like,
it's just like,
you know, I mean, like, you'd just be Gidget and not Super Spy Gidget.
Sometimes I stub my toe.
You know?
I have soul. I listen to Ed Sheeran.
Oh, yeah.
This seems like
about Ed Sheeran.
Is that Mr. Ed?
Oh, yeah.
I feel like there's some tension here that I know nothing about, guys. Is there something we need to work through?
No.
No.
What music inspires you?
That was really quick. I feel like that was really quick.
Alright.
To take you away from the tension.
Well, yours is a little closed off from everybody else.
Blackhead, is there anything you'd like to say?
Yeah, I was just about to say something, but people gotta run their big mouth!
So you guys have been spending a lot of time in the horse trailer together, I feel.
Yeah,
some would say a little too much!
I can, you know, and I feel like that's the thing that every band goes through, is, like, getting used to, like, spending all of that time together and, like, creating this family unit.
I'm a simple horse. Just do the dishes.
I agree.
I use paper plates.
That's not good for the environment.
I agree.
Darn.
Exactly. I'll hurry.
Hello?
Hey there, Scurvy.
Hello?
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 What's up, John?
I had a question for Seahorse, actually. I haven't been able. This is the voice of
John.
This is the guy in the other room.
Right here.
Well, it's tonight. It's Zeus.
Zeus. Actually, I had a question in regards to that. You know, in the upcoming elections, who are you pulling for, Ursula or King Neptune?
Oh, that's a
definitely the giant douche.
The turd sandwich.
Turd sandwich.
It's a turd sandwich.
Turd sandwich.
Of the deep, Ursula or Neptune. So you're thinking Neptune.
Jimmy Hick.
Well, I mean, like, I feel like with your extensive lifespans and experiences and the weight of all of your past lives, like, you guys should have some really good insight as far as how these decisions might play out.
I'd love to tell you that we knew where the Earth was headed, but honestly, I have no clue.
Me neither. I think we're all the same.
Well, I don't really belong to any political spectrum. I'm more of a nihilist.
Mm-hmm. More of a nihilist?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You have no clue because you have your head up your arse.
I can't do that. I haven't been that direction.
Seems like in a horse trailer, it'd be much easier to have your heads up your
arse. Should I just say, I have no idea what he's been saying this whole time?
Okay, guys, I'm going to need you to speak one at a time because there's a microphone right above you and we can't understand you if you shout at the same time.
This is what I'm talking about. This is what I'm talking about.
I feel your pain.
He stinks. I smell him right now.
Yeah, he needs to work on his hygiene a little bit.
Well, I haven't even started with you.
Okay, so let's go back to the music. Because that's really what it's all about, right?
Yeah,
this is why
we
do these things and why we put up with all of this stuff is because the music, right?
Right.
It brings you together.
And the music is what keeps you together and keeps you playing and in the trailer day after day after day.
It's inspiration to pull from.
Stop biting your teeth.
So if Aquaman were to pick a fight with you guys, what would be your best move against him?
Well, I'd ask him if he likes fish sticks.
You'd have a bad time.
That would ask him what?
If he likes fish sticks.
If he likes fish sticks.
Yeah,
fish sticks. Well, it all depends on how you're taking it.
Fish sticks.
Love them.
Got it.
Yeah.
I have a feeling he loves fish sticks.
I feel like a good
that
uppercut.
Him and Kanye.
I tell you one thing.
A good uppercut would really, really do it to him, you know?
Yeah.
That was my answer to that.
Is an uppercut.
Good uppercut.
Yeah.
That might win.
Thank you very much.
How do you guys feel about Aquaman and the comics?
Well, an uppercut, too.
Is that a thing for you guys?
Take off the spandex, dude. Who are you trying to fool?
You know, I feel that way about a lot of superheroes.
How would you know?
What?
How would you know if he's hiding something?
Because he's wearing spandex.
Yarr.
So
there.
Yeah,
well, it could be just a bunch of fish in a leotard. We don't really know.
This is true.
Wait.
I mean, it's true. Like, that might be why it wiggles so much.
Yeah, and, you know, that's why I talk to other fish.
I got cabin fever.
I don't know. This is not where I saw this conversation going. So, where are you guys playing next?
Over there.
Well, like, over there in, like, 5 minutes, probably.
Uh-huh.
And then, after that.
Oh.
Where can our audience see more seahorse?
The camel.
The camel?
The camel.
All the time.
All the time?
Usually.
Any particular
dates
coming up?
Well, not every night, but,
I love camels.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of the camel. I've had you guys playing there the other night was awesome. That's where I see most of my favorite bands.
Thank you.
I agree.
Well, where can we find you if we want to know more? If we can't, we don't have those dates anymore. But are you on social media?
Like, where can we, find your dates when they get announced?
Facebook.
And Insta.
And how do you spell
Instagram?
Yeah.
Okay, ready, everyone? Let's see if we can do one thing right. Ready? We're going to
spell
out our name.
Phoenician alphabet.
Ready?
No, maybe.
It doesn't matter.
Those Minneapolis Centaurs will have our heads again.
I don't want to talk about Minneapolis again.
One more time for our audience, correct me if I'm wrong, but it's S-E-A-W-H-O-R-S-E.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay, so that would make a much better game for, that horse game for me. I feel like I would do better. It would give me time to practice before the end.
Before the race?
Yeah.
Did you, when you were in Minneapolis, did you get to interact with Prince much? And have you talked to him lately?
Well, Prince was deceased.
I feel like I'm getting a look from a mule. Is this an uncomfortable subject?
Quite.
Yeah.
Sorry, Barbara.
Okay,
we love Prince, though.
I mean, who doesn't? You have to in some way, just out of respect for Little Red Beret.
When horses cry.
Raspberry beret.
Raspberry beret. Little red Corvette.
Yeah.
Raspberry
beret.
You were on the right colors.
I like both of those songs.
Yeah, I'm good.
Yeah. I like Raspberry Parfait.
I love Raspberry Parfait.
I love parfaits.
Parfaits are
good.
What?
All for parfaits? Say aye.
Especially
raspberry
ones.
Aye.
And I think on that note, we should probably get to our next break.
We spelled it correctly eventually, right?
We did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right.
Well, yeah, we're going to get to one more little break here. And we're going to be back with one more live one from Seahorse here on Radio Rubber Room. But right now, we're going to hear from Handsome Professor. This is Summer Stains. And again, this is Radio Rubber Room.
And the angels were bored. So they threw all their love on me. Too much for me to keep stored. And it creeps through my skin, attracting rampant rewards. Their wings were slit. Their wings are intoxicated, no less. Desperate blackbirds, they stain their beaks, brew songs on vintage gone bad. Summer.
They say it's tough to find a needle in a haystack, but if you want a real challenge, try to find the hay in a needle stack.
Yoga, long since known as an art form to balance the body and mind. Well, that's great for the ladies and sissy boys, but what about the manly men?
Yeah!
I'm 80s heavy metal band Vomit's bassist and retired Triple C Wrestling League champion, Viper Cobra. And you may not know this, but I am an extreme yoga professional.
Yoga professional.
Now my moves are available for you to master. The Viper Cobra's badass yoga studio is now open.
So extreme.
There will be no mountain salutations or downward facing dog in my program. Try moves like take your foot and put it on the ceiling. I don't care how you get it there, just get it there.
Yeah.
You're gonna stretch until you bleed. Don't think you can stretch that much? Wait till I burn you with cigarettes.
Yeah.
I keep the walls of my yoga dojo lined with Rottweilers who have been listening to Godsmack 24/7.
They're foaming at the mouth.
This raises the intensity level to the max.
To the max.
Extreme. I spent the 90s in San Quentin perfecting my signature moves, like birth a baby polar bear.
Yeah.
And squeeze a scorpion in your fist.
Extreme.
Stretch till it hurts. Then punch yourself in the stomach repeatedly. Grab both ears and stretch them out as far from your head as possible.
So extreme.
Make sure to keep breathing like a heaving vulture. Extreme.
Yeah.
Extreme.
Yeah.
Here at Viper Cobra's badass yoga studio, you're gonna bend over backwards and lick the ground. Or I'm gonna throw an angry snake at your face.
Snake at your face.
Extreme.
Yeah, we're gonna inject protein shakes right in your chest.
Yeah.
Right in your chest.
Protein shake.
Protein shake.
Protein shake.
Directly into your chest.
Extreme.
Yeah.
New from Spoofco, it's Radio Rubber Room action figures.
All right!
Now you can play along with your favorite character from the show. Choose from one of the three different hosts with an array of accessories, weapons, and superpowers. The Derek action figure transforms into a solar-powered Prius that shoots hacky sack projectiles.
Take that!
The Derek action figure comes pre-programmed with catchphrases like,
if it's yellow, let it mellow.
And,
I never use soap, brah. It's bad for the environment.
Each Derek action figure comes with a bottle of cactus juice.
Feel the healing power of the cactus fruit, man.
He won't shut up about,
I'm totally gonna have sex with this juice.
Radio Rubber Room action figures. New from Spoofco. Collect all three.
Begin with you, Charlie. The shotgun you keep under the bar. Pick it up by the barrels. Easy.
Thought you were gonna ask for a drink. Been a long dry spell.
Shotgun first. Set it down. Back. Guess I'll take that drink now, Charlie.
I thought you would, but.
Live here on Radio Rubber Room. That was wonderful.
That was cool, guys.
I loved it.
I liked that a lot. All right, over there?
You guys, everyone okay?
That was
was an emotional one.
Did you,
Yeah, tug to my heartstrings, that one.
Right.
Did you black out a little bit there, or?
Oh, he always does.
Oh, okay. So that's normal?
Yeah.
That one felt more emotional. Is that
you
how it normally
wallet,
goes?
Yeah.
You got your wallet, that's always good.
It sounded to me like an underwater gunslinging spaghetti Wild West underwater battle.
You're damn right.
Well, that's Italian food.
Love Italian food.
Yeah.
Especially underwater.
Indeed, a little citrus in here.
It's all,
loose spaghetti.
Yeah.
So, we've enjoyed having you guys. Glad you could make it. Before we go, anything else you've got to tell the people that we haven't covered yet?
I'm forgetting something.
You're forgetting something?
I know their next date is October 24th at Campbell.
That's it.
Way to go, Cara.
That's
way
right.
to go, Cara.
On the ball.
Who is that with? Do you know?
That is with the...
Oh, that's with the Cosmonaut Collaborative.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Saving
Absolutely.
The day.
When is
saving
it?
The day. October
24th.
Oh, I was just
going to
say.
October 24th.
Can you write that down for me?
October 24th, I will.
I got a gig that day.
I'm pretty sure that
I think
your
that's
gig
your
that
gig. You'll be there, front and center.
Okay.
So if you just remember that gig, you'll be at the right place.
You'll be at the right place. And so will everyone else. And October 24th is Campbell.
All right, every of you.
Yeah.
Okay,
yes, that's right.
So I'll see you guys there. And
if
we want to hear any more Seahorse before then, we will go to seahorse.bandcamp.com.
Correct.
Seahorserva.bandcamp.
Seahorserva.bandcamp.com.
There may or may not be a promo video coming out for the new album.
That's exciting.
So watch out for Land Ho.
Keep the suspense.
Land Ho.
Land Ho.
That's the name of the new album?
Nope.
I like it. No?
No.
I'm just saying Land Ho.
Okay. All right.
We can check for those updates on Facebook.
Galaxified.
See you.
Right, well, thank you guys so much for being here.
Yes.
We really appreciate it. Thank you so much for enlightening us on Seahorse culture and your extended view and your take on everything.
I've learned a lot.
You can find out even more at seahorse.gov.
Seahorse.gov, okay.
So you can vote. You can sign up to vote.
Okay.
Eggs, bacon, Trump.
All right, and to, as always, to hear more RVA music and get the latest in what's up and coming right here in RVA, tune in to RadioRubberRoom.com. Come on out to our Radio Rubber Room Presents concert series at the Camel every other Wednesday night through the end of the year. We'll see you there.
And honestly, I don't think you smell that bad. I've been sitting next to you for quite a while now.
I think it's fine.
And I'm really impressed by the breathing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah, way to overcome.
Thank you.
Way to overcome.
I don't say that to everyone.
Maybe High you five. Should be in his band.
Hold it.
Respect.
On the way out, do you guys want to spell Seahorse one more time for everybody?
Oh, God. Oh.
I already forgot.
Can I help you?
You want to do it?
I mean, I can help you.
I can help.
Okay.
Kara can help.
Are we getting hooked on phonics over here?
So, S-E-A-W-H-O-R-S-E. RBA.bandcamp.com.
Or Facebook.
Or Facebook. Check it in. Tune in. Subscribe. Do those things.
Like all that jazz.
Support your local music scene. What's up?
We got one more tune before we get out for you. These guys are actually from Philly, but they're going to be down here playing Radio Urban Presents tonight.
October
19th. With Alice in the Reverie.
And Megan Burt and The Cure for Love. This is Tweed, I'm going to go with, from their new album, yet to be released. This is a premiere, right? Yeah, on Radio Rubber Room.
This is Real World by Tweed. Good night.
summer.